Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are well and safe at your home. So this video is for the students of class 9, subject science, chapter number 3, that is atoms and molecules. In this lecture, I would be discussing the solutions of assignment number 1. So let's start. Question number 1 was, burn a candle, explain where the wax mass has gone. So students, when you burn a candle, what will you observe? You will observe that when a candle is burnt, wax, it starts melting into liquid. Okay, the wax, it will melt to form liquid. Okay, and the heat of the flame, it will vaporize these wax molecules. Means, it will turn into hot gas. And these wax molecules, they will react with oxygen present in air. Okay, so this was the answer of question number 1. Coming to question number 2. Question number 2 was, what is U or AMU? 1 U is equal to how many grams? So what is U or AMU? It is actually one and the same thing. This is atomic mass unit. So what is atomic mass unit? It is a mass unit equal to 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon 12 isotope. Okay, and this atomic mass unit, it is represented as U, that is unified mass, or AMU, that is atomic mass unit. Okay, and this 1U is equal to how many grams? This 1U, it is equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 grams. Okay, this is the relationship between 1U into grams. You can note it down. Okay, now coming to question number 3. Question number 3 was, write what data you need to know the number of atoms in 100 gram of element X. Okay, you are given an element X. Okay, and mass is given 100 gram. And you have to calculate number of atoms. What is the formula for calculating the number of atoms? Given mass divided by molecular mass into Avogadro's number. You know given mass. You don't know molecular mass and you know Avogadro's number. So what data you need? You need molecular mass. So the answer is molecular mass. Question number 3. Because you are given an element X and you are not given which element is this. If you know the element, you can know the molecular mass. So this is question number 3. Question number 4 is, write an equation to calculate the number of atoms in element X weighing y kg. Okay, you have been given element X and the mass is given y kg. So, just write down the equation for calculating the number of atoms. What is the formula for calculating the number of atoms? It is given mass divided by molecular mass into Avogadro's number. This is the formula for calculating the number of atoms. Now you are given the given mass, that is y kg. Convert this kg into gram. 1 kg is 10 raised to the power 3 grams or 1000 gram. So given mass is y into 10 raised to the power 3 What is the molecular mass? Molecular mass is not given in the question. So I have assumed the molecular mass as mx. Means molecular mass of element x. Sorry, this is capital X. Okay? And I have Guidry's number, you know, that is 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23. So this is the equation you can calculate. Given mass, y into 10 raised to power 3. Why 10 raised to power 3? Because we are converting into gram. In question, it is kg, y kg. So convert into grams, 10 raised to power 3 gram. Multiply. So molecular mass, you don't know, mx. And Avogadro's number, you have written the value. So this is the equation for calculating the number of atoms. Okay, students. Coming to question number 5. Question number 5 is, find out the number of alpha particles if they all together weigh 10 gram. So given mass is given 10 gram. And the mass of one alpha particle is 4U. The mass is 4U. And 1U is equal to 1.66 into 10 raised to power minus 24 gram. So 4U is given. Convert this into grams by multiplying this 1.66 into 10 raised to power minus 24. So this is the molar mass. So just apply the formula for calculating the number of alpha particles. Given mass by molar mass into Avogadro's number. Given mass is given 10 gram. Molar mass is 4 into 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24. And Avogadro's number, you know the value. Just substitute the values and calculate the answer. So the answer is 9.069 into 10 to the power 47. Okay. So this is question number 5. Question number 6 is, the richest man in the world has $50 billion. It has $50 billion in his account. How many moles of dollar he has? Means we have to calculate the moles, number of moles. So first of all, what is 50 billion? That will be 10 to the power 9 dollars. Okay. So 1 billion is 10 to the power 9. So 50 billion will be 50 into 10 to the power 9 dollars. Okay. Now you know that 1 mole is equal to 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 particles. So this much number of dollar particles here we can substitute with dollar. So this much dollar is 1 mole. I have just reversed the equation. This much dollar is 1 mole. And you need to calculate in this much dollar. So 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 dollars is 1 mole. Calculate for 1. It will be 1 divided by Avogadro's number. And calculate for this now. 50 into 10 to the power 9. That will be multiplied by this whole. Just apply the unitary method as you do in mathematics. Okay. So the answer is 0.83 into 10 to the power minus 30 moles. Because we are asked in moles. So it is moles. Just simple. Convert into this simplest form. 10 to the power 9. And just apply the unitary method. Question number 7. The human population of world is 800 crore. Convert in into moles. You have to convert this into moles. 800 crore. So 800 crore is equal to how many people? It will be 800 into 10 to the power 7 people. Okay. In 1 crore how many zeros are there? There are 7 zeros. So 800 to the 10 to the power 7 people. Okay, now you know that 1 mole is Avogadro's number into particles. Sorry, Avogadro's number of particles. So I can substitute these particles by people now. So 1 mole is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 people. So just reverse, I have applied the unitary method. And this much number of people, we have 1 mole. Calculate for 1, it will be divided by, and calculate for 800 into 10 to the power 7 people. So it will get multiplied. Just applying the unitary method and calculate the answer. The answer is 1.328 into 10 to the power minus 14 moles. Okay. This much number of people is 1 mole. Calculate for 1. Calculate for this by unitary method. Same as we did in question number 6. Alright students. Coming to question number 8. Question number 8 was, find out the approx number of H2 atoms in 1 gram of H2 if one hydrogen atom weighs approximately 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. Okay, we are given in this question that the hydrogen atom weighs means mass, the weighs it is this much number of grams. Okay, you have to calculate the number of hydrogen H2 atoms. You have to calculate H2 atoms. So in this one hydrogen atom, this is the mass. Calculate for H2. H2 means 2 hydrogen atom. This is H plus H. 2H. Okay, so for 1 it is given, for 2H it will be. Sorry, for H2 it will be twice of this. So 2 into 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. That will become a molecule basically. This is atom, hydrogen. It is molecule. So that's why I've written molecular mass. So it will become twice. Now we are given in the question that first of all apply the formula. Number of atoms is equal to given mass upon molar mass into Avogadro's number. What is given mass? Given mass is given, that is 1 gram. In the question it is given 1 gram of H2. So 1 gram is given mass. What is the molecular mass of H2? You have calculated now. That will become double of this. And what is Avogadro's number? You know the value. So just substitute the value. 1 divided by 2 into 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 multiplied by Avogadro's number, that is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Just solve the equation. You will get your answer. The answer is 1.81 into 10 to the power 47. Okay. Just simple. First of all, write down the formula. Number of atoms is given mass by molar mass into Avogadro's number. Given mass is given in the question, that is 1 gram. Now molecular mass you can calculate easily. That will become twice of this. It is hydrogen atom. For molecule it will become twice because it is H2. H2 means twice of hydrogen. So twice of this and Avogadro's number you go. Simple. So alright students, this is question number 8 solution. Moving ahead to question number 9. Question number 9 was, if 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms of H2 weighs 1 gram. Approximately then 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 H2 molecule would weigh how much? For hydrogen atom it is given. You have to calculate for molecule. So you know that in one molecule of hydrogen H2, it contains how many atoms? There are 2 atoms. Okay. So, if one molecule contains 2 atoms, so 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 molecules will contain twice of this. That will be twice of 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Okay. Now, just see, for this much atom, we know it is given 1 gram. Okay, for this much atom, we know it is 1 gram. And if it is given twice, it will become twice gram, 2 grams. Okay, up to here, the answer was coming in atoms. But we are asked in the question, the mass in grams. And you know that this much number of atoms weighs 1 gram. So how much about double of this? It will be double of this. That will be 2 into 1. That is 2 grams. Okay? Moving ahead to question number 10th. Question number 10th was 2H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O. Okay. Now in this reaction, calculate the minimum mass in grams of oxygen needed to prepare 18 gram of water. Okay. Now you know that 2H2, it means what is the molecular mass? For one hydrogen it is 1. There are 2 hydrogen atom, it will become 2. And it is twice of this, it will become 4. So 4U. O2, what is the atomic mass of one oxygen? It is 16. Twice of 16, 32. Similarly, calculate for water, it will be 36. So 4U, 32U, 36U. This you know. Now what is given in the question? The question it is asked that calculate the minimum mass of oxygen atom. You have to calculate for oxygen atom which is needed to prepare 18 gram of water. Okay. This U it is changing to gram. One and the same thing. Okay. So you have to calculate for 18. For 36 you know it is 32 gram. 36 gram of water. It needs 32 gram of oxygen. Calculate for 1 gram of water. Then calculate for 18 gram of water. Just applying the unitary method. So 32 by 36 into 80. The answer will be 16 gram of oxygen. Okay. First of all, write down what is given in the question. Then calculate what you know about it. And just simplify. So answer is 16 gram of oxygen. Coming to the last question, question number 11th. In question number 11, a reaction is given x3 plus 3y2 is equal to 3xy2. Now you will have to find the minimum mass in gram of x and y. You have to calculate for x, you have to calculate for y, which is needed to prepare 54 gram of xy2. Okay, the mass is given in the question of xy2, that is 54 gram. And it is also given that the x3 molecule, it is 24 times of y2 molecule. So means x3 is equal to 24 times of y2 molecule. So these two things are given in the question. Now just apply your brain. Substitute these two values in this equation. x3 is given 24 y2. So 24y2 plus 3y2 is equal to 3xy2. xy2 you know 54 gram. So substitute 3 into 54 and calculate the value of y2 from here. You will get your answer, that is 6 gram. Now substitute this value of y2 in this equation and calculate for x3. That will be x3 plus 3y2. Okay, 3y2. 3 into y2. y2 you have calculated. 3 into 6 is equal to 3xy2. 3 into xy2. xy2 is given 54. So 3 into 54. So just simplify. You will get the value of x3 also. So your answer is 144 gram for x and 6 gram for y. Okay, it is just simple. Write down what is given in the question, then just substitute the values in the equation and calculate for x, calculate for y. Okay, thank you, students. Have a nice day.